chunfu kafe wava do junu nu fi kafe akraki ta megbe ta zane dole ge kafe mi zodu yo kitipu megbe
eyen da fuga ka kan ye kunyo ma wundi ye wa ma fa ko
le ye bi nye vovo e bi ye mo ata fa ga mata ye de ka ku le ga ma kafe mi di vi gba to kafe onye di la pra ka ga po nye po
e ko yi ga ma ma buta ma buta ba nu lanu ko won me be ali awo ha re ko le gba ku ju yo mi owu ko fo
Chukwu ma ji ha ye ko ke fi ma ga du nye no no ha pere je bi me bi ma di go la fu pe pe ma ka fe ga ba le ka nyu tu ma ka ha ga po bi nya nu mu nye ka va wo ne ma ko na bi ni mu le fi ke ta bu bu o ma ma no ha
Welcome.
Welcome. Welcome. Yeah, welcome. No, no, Kunya, Aka. No, no,
Aka. What's the tongue? Those people, the Bible people making this, they are lying.
Kunya, my photo. What's your name? You're saying you know what I'm going to do? I like it. I'm going to go. Kunya, my photo. You're much better, my man. Hey, that means I'm going I'm not going to be able to get the money. I'm not going to be able to get the money.
I'm going to be able to get the
money. I'm going to be able to get the money. I'm going to be able to get the money. I'm going to be able
to get the money. Bo ma fu pa me ma jibe ma abe a o ma ga share ko yin to yin pe pe
I want to strongly and categorically state that the Trokosi story or issue is a fraud. It's a fraud. It's some amazing thing some people did in this country, which is a crime against the black race, which is an insult to the black image, that at this computer age there is a place in the community where women are kept, children are kept, they don't give them food, they beat them, and the leaders of the shrine have illicit sex with them. It's a lie. We vow at Africania Mission that nobody will come from anywhere to ask us about this Trokosi matter. We will mind him, because we told the truth all these years, nobody mind. When we tell the truth, people go, then they distort the truth. So I'm sure you are also not going to distort it. If you distort it, this one is a spiritual matter. In Africa, we respect women a lot. So we don't have a system where we abuse women.
Like you know, Trokosi, for us women, human rights activists, we feel that it is one of the grievous forms of violence against women. It's been abolished in Ghana way back in 1998. The criminal code was amended to make it a crime, you know, punishable under our laws. There are those also who believe strongly, even among intellectuals, that that is their custom, and there is nothing wrong with it, and they want to continue. Yeah, I think that issues of abuse are still very pervasive in our society, yeah, because of the way we have been socialized. You know, women have been made to believe that they are subservient to men, and therefore, even if there is abuse and they report it, then they are going, you know, against the rules, you know. So a lot of human rights organizations, especially I know about international needs, they are really on the fore trying to negotiate and to find ways of liberating some of these women.
innocent girl who knows nothing about the offense or will not be related in any way will be sent to the shrine to serve for a crime which she has not committed. Any children they have still remains the responsibility of these young girls and their parents. And so if parents are scared and abandon these children, they actually live in very difficult situations, which is the case most of the time.
Slave. Ama vi akluvi ama plaple mavi wa mala ya nya lakpa. The girls will go around. When they get you, they'll punish you. And if you don't take time, when you die, the girls can demand that somebody from your family should come and worship over here and serve. To serve as a deterrent to the rest of the people in your community or in your house. As for that one, you are coming to serve as a Trokosi. That is it.
They are treating us, it's not good. We don't wear shirts, we wear barefoot, we walk like that. I decided that I will not go to that place again because the person who have done the thing, they should go to the place themselves. And my relative, those who have sent me there, they are ready to see me. If they see me any place, they can take me to the shrine. Because if they don't take me there, they will do revenge to their family and kill them. I would like to help the Trokosi. And I will go to the shrine or to the town and preach to the any one of them who I meet on the way on the or the community. I'll preach the gospel to them so that he also or she also come out from there.
The Trokosi project started as far back as 1986. We give them an opportunity to train in skills that are hands-on that will help them, like mat weaving, sewing, batik tie dye, bead making, and all those.
All believers are called the slaves of the gods. That's how they are called. And that is what they've been sent there to do. To be the wives of the gods and to take care of them. And they will have no choice. If you belong, how can you choose between what God has asked you to do? You don't have a choice.